Hi everyone and welcome back. Today I'm going to set up this gorgeous holo planner. I've had this for ages and haven't set it up. I'm not quite sure why. I think probably I moved to B6 shortly after buying it. I don't know, I can't quite remember. Not B6, A5, sorry. And I had plans to turn it into maybe a sticker album, and I might still do that eventually, but I have a project coming up that I wanted to set this up for, and I just want to set it up because it's so cute. But then Kiki K sent me this gorgeous pink blush quilted fabulousness at B6, and I thought maybe I should use this for my project, but I have an idea of something else I could use that for. So I'm going to leave it, and I'm going to keep this for the project, because I have some really cute things I want to put in here, and some bits and pieces, and I can't wait to show you. So when I bought it, it came with a little, you can see this extra bit here, it had a tassel hanging off there. So if you can see at the top of my frame here, I've got this garland, and I was very tempted to take one of these poms off of here and attach it to the ring pull. Maybe, but I do have a charm as well that might be appropriate. So I think I'll wait right till the end before I do that. Let me take you through the planner. It is, as you can see, iridescent. People are going to ask if it gets dirty. Sure, it has little, I don't know if you can even tell, that's the thing, right? It's so bright and shiny that I think the fingerprints or whatever marks are on there really don't matter. And there is something therapeutic as well about just wiping it clean. Like if you're sitting in a meeting and you're wiping your planner. Does anyone else do that? Is it just me? Anyway, it's plasticky and glorious. I really love it. I think it's awesome. So inside the planner, I have in the front, so you can see there's white rings. I have the Kiki K Holo pen that came with the Count Your Lucky Stars range. I love this pen. It is fine point and fabulous. I have this piece of holo jelly dashboard from Studio Marlowe. It is spectacular. So that has to stay in here, of course. And then I have the dividers, which came with the planner, and they are holo as well. There's a ruler in here, and I think I'm going to switch them out. They're really cute, but I have an idea for a different type of a dashboard that I'll show you in a second. So I've got some grid paper and some lined paper that both you can buy separately from Kiki K. I've got the two new pages that came in this planner. I've got some more grid paper there. And some more grid paper. I love grid paper, in case you didn't know. And, oh, that's right. In the back, I put some black paper. So I want to just muck around with some pens and foil and stuff. So I'm not sure if that's the key for this particular planner once I've set it up. And I've got the notes pages that came with it. In the back, it comes with this holo pocket. How can I not keep that? And then it has this other, like a dashboard at the back, which has the notepad in a little slot here. So you can actually swap that out for the notepad replacements. It has a pocket in here to put things in. And this whole thing is a pocket as well. So lots of storage options with this little planner. So I'll keep this and this in because they kind of become the page lifter at the back, like the page lifter. Obviously the pen loop, I'll stick the pen in there as well. Now, I don't know, these dashboards are so cool. I'm just going to put them aside for the moment because I have with me my Thrive Pink Lavender planner, which is currently set up, but I'm not using it. It's an old setup. But these dividers are spectacular. So I made these myself from paper from Ellie Beth Designs UK, and I absolutely adore it. So I'm just going to pop the dividers out. This planner is packed. I'm not quite sure why. I don't even know what it used it for. So let me just put this one to the side. I'll do it on camera so you can see the things I'm taking out. So here's the front divider. I've got my little twinkle, the unicorn on the back. And I'll just rescue the paper, I guess. So I'll keep what was in there. But obviously I've put some grid paper in here. I've got some notes. It's got grid paper at the back, but it's old one that I printed myself, so not so neat. This is obviously the planner that I used when I was doing the Kiki K planner insider thingy. This is from Arabeya. Here's a planner pouch that I made. I love this. There's a video on how to do these. Very cute. Some more note paper, which I might put to the side as well. This little die cut I made from, you know who it is, Milo and Milk. Another dashboard here. Just get these notes behind that. It's kind of work stuff. This divider, and then in the back I have a dashboard, which I think I'll just leave in here because I don't really need it. I have this pocket with some business cards in. Actually, I'll leave that in there as well because I'm going to make some new business cards. I have this dashboard from Pumpkin Paper Co., which says Mouth Breather. It's 11 from Stranger Things. And then I have a couple of sticky notes on the back, so I'll keep that. And I have this pocket as well that has some of my favorite little tiny stickers in it from samplers, so I will keep that into the new planner as well. And then right at the back is just some old spreads, which were actually really good fun. Oh, I love looking at the old spreads. And right in the back I've got this notepad, just a normal notepad that I just covered with some vellum, so maybe this vellum could be useful as well. Anyway, I will leave it for the moment. Actually, I won't. I'll bring the vellum. I just paperclipped it to there. So it's already punched for a personal size planner. So that's cool. Okay, and in the front here, I've got some acetate with gold stars. But I'm going to leave that in there as well. And I have these die cuts and things, but I might leave them for the moment too. So I'll just put this glorious planner to the side. I do miss being in that one, but I'm also looking forward to having some fun things with this hollow goodness. Okay, let's start by popping the dividers in. I'll put my little business card pocket thingy in the back and my 11 dashboard, and then the dividers, actually I won't put in just yet because I want to take off this label, and I don't know if it's going to come off very well because it is actually paper it comes off perfectly. Wow, that's awesome. While I'm here, I don't know if you can see this divider has a very pointy edge, so I might just round that off a little with my scissors because it seems to have degraded a little over time anyway. So I'll put that in there. I love this next one as well. It's so pretty with the sleepy unicorn. Adorable. I think she still does this paper. I'm not absolutely certain. I used to be on the design team. This was the first thing I bought from her shop. It was a creative pack which had a whole bunch of papers and vellum and acetate and stickers and die cuts, all sorts of things. A little sticky note in the back there that seems a bit useless. And then this last one. So we've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 sections in here, as opposed to 7 that you get in the Kiki K dividers when you first buy the planner. And so my battery's getting low there, so. So, if we put these in here, upside down, And I will trim this off as well. It's gotten a lot, it's gotten quite bent. That one's not so bad. Okay, so that's pretty adorable. Okay, and I've got some other bits and pieces that I need to make with you. So I'll put this to the side. We have our jelly dash, we have this little guy, a planner pouch, and so I made this into a planner pouch as well. And I just chucked these little coffee and pencil stickers from Kiki K in there. I'm not sure if this really goes with the theme of the planner, so I might leave it to the side for the moment. And I want to show you the other bits and pieces that I have, which I'll have to like cut and stuff. So I do have, as I said, the vellum. So I have this really pretty drawing that came just out of a magazine. I've just chopped it up out of a magazine. It's Breathe magazine, which I think is a New Zealand magazine. So it's just paper, but in the same magazine they had lots of pages that have like a watercolor effect on it. So I thought I could potentially back it with that. But I also have, so that's those two. Also out of the magazine, as you can see. I also have this dashboard that I was a printable from, oh, I can't pronounce the name of the shop. It's L-A-Z-N-Y-E shop, Lazny shop. 5% unicorn, 95% planner babe. Perfect for this planner. And I have this bit of offcut, which I've cut down to a perfect personal size, and I thought I might make a washi dashboard with this bit of paper. So it could be backed by one of these as well. So perhaps this could be backed with a washi, or maybe this could be the back of the washi card. You know, something like that. That's my plan, loose plan so far. So this one needs to be made. And also from the same shop, I bought some a digital paper, and you can see I've run it through my mink and I have foiled it. I haven't taken it off yet. I thought we could do that together. So let's do it. Oh, look at that. So it's this constellation digital paper, and I've used this amazing I don't know, I think it's called Square Hollow. I did a little haul of it. It is so cool. So I thought I would cut that down as well, and I really love the kind of negative of these things as well. So I'll put that to the side, and I need to cut this down to personal size. So I'll just grab this bit of paper that I've already cut down. And excuse the traffic. So I'm going to cut this so that I don't get the edge. You know, the paper, the print always kind of goes not all the way to the edge. So make sure we're in frame here. I'll just make a mark where I want to cut it. And so because it's a printable, it's mine now, right? I can print as many of these as I like and put them in all the planners. So I kind of have like a constellation, hollow, unicorn, you know, all the things thing happening in this planner. I think it can handle it because it's so bright and fun and cool. All right, I might as well just cut this down straight away. I will use that trimmer again in a minute. So I'll just check. Yeah, that's pretty close to the size of all the others. Okay, so it's all coming together. Move this to the side. What I also have with me is the Planners Anonymous So 90s box. And in here, there is this set of papers. And I just thought I'd have a look and see if it might be relevant. I thought this one would be kind of cool because it's hollow and stuff. So I might use that. I'm not sure if this is really what I'm going for. So I might not use quite like the pens, but I'm not sure I'm loving the yellow. And that's the paper version of the acetate and the back of it. So I think I don't want to use any of those just yet. I'll come back to it. The dashboards I think I won't decorate because they are pretty busy already with those unicorn patterns. So I think I will not use those. So I'm just going to cut a personal size piece of this acetate and we will be good to go. Okay, so now we have this one, which is perfect size on there. All right, so maybe what we'll do next is punch everything. Actually, no, let's make the washi dash. Okay, so we're just, if you haven't made a washi dash before, it's pretty simple. Choose a bunch of washi that you want to use. And I want to use these celestial ones from Hobby Hoppers. There's this big, thick one, so it's going to make the process quite quick. And then there's this thinner one that is just kind of standard size. Both silver foil. This one is navy. This one is black. I thought I'd bring in the skinny silver. And also, I want to bring in the pink Simply Gilded ones, probably. I think it will add a little bit of dimension, I guess, because they're much lighter. So I'm just going to start with a big piece of this to go in the corner. And I do like to do, obviously we start in a diagonal fashion and we just have to make sure we get all of the washi on the corner like so. So I'm just going to stick it to my bench, I think, at this point. I'm going to put the silver one in between. I'm actually half tempted to take it out of this dispenser. Now I got my silver washi also from Hobby Hoppers. It's very cool. It came in the pack with all of the metallics. And then maybe we should do the pink now just to see how that goes. I'm not quite sure if I'm going to get enough. I don't want to waste it and have too much to cut off. I think the pink will just, you know, it's my planner, so it's going to have some pink. Okay, that's cool. And then we'll put in the skinnier black. Excellent. I hope this is not going to stick too hard to my bench. Okay, so now I'll use the thicker pink. Oh, I don't think I cut that long enough. Okay, I'll save that for at the top. That's always the problem, is not quite tearing enough off. And then when we're placing it down, you just want to make sure you get it straight against the edge of the last one. Otherwise, it's not quite as neat as I'd like. All right, so the next is the big one again. So I need a fair amount to cover that whole space. I hope this is enough. It's plenty. So I might just come close to one end. Because then I can, when I cut it off the other end, I'll be able to save some of it. Just get it down straight without getting my head in the way. Not quite. And I have torn the paper as well a little bit. Okay, let's try that again. That's better. Okay. Excellent. I'm thinking I should have put the silver one in there as well, but I didn't, so that's a shame. But anyway, not to worry. There's no right or wrong. Just whatever makes you feel good, right? And it's a good way to use up scrap paper. And obviously a great way to waste wash. But I think it looks good. I like it. I'm going to go with the skinny pink again. I'm not really doing any particular order. Oh, too short. Okay, that is annoying. Sometimes it's useful to actually do this with the washi off the roll so that, you know, take off the dispenser, I mean, and put it on the roll. Oh, so my see-throughness there is not good. I might wipe that out. All right, not perfect by any means, but still pretty cute. Okay. Right, so we'll do the little moon one next. I guess I'm going to have to go a little bit longer than I'm thinking just to make sure I get it to the edge. There we go. I'm just so loath to waste the Silver Gilder one. Cost so much to get here. Oh, it's looking pretty cute. I wonder if I should zoom you in a little. I know that we're off the edge of the frame a little there. Sorry about that, but it's stuck to the table now. I'm going to put a silver slice in. I know it's close to the other one, but I just feel like it needs it. Funny, some of them go down so easily. Beautiful. Okay, so let's see if I'm okay for this piece that I cut earlier. No, I'm not. It's still too short. How about another skinny? Also too short. Okay. Well, I might use that in a spread at some point. I think maybe the big one again could actually go in here. As long as it doesn't take up the whole rest of the page. I do want to get a bit more pink in. Oh, I love that that washi constellations. I'll put our pink bows in here. And then another little strip of the silver. Like so. And I think I want to finish it off with something dark, so I'll go with the moon one again. Okay, so my battery ran out while I was doing that, but I just kept going. What I've done is left the corner ones, because if I fold this down, it's going to fold over the edge, you know, like your old school textbooks. So I can either just cut a slit in here till it meets the edge, which means I can fold this one over without any problems. Or, again, like the old textbooks, when I used to cover them with brown paper, I would just cut the edges off like this. Like, also like wrapping a present sometimes, we want to be extra neat. And some of them we can just trim off because they are small enough. This one I'll trim off as well. Now I can just fold that over. I can fold that over, and I can fold that over. And then lastly, let's remove this washi. I haven't set up my little rubbish bin yet. I'll hopefully do that tomorrow. And this one. So now we have, oh look, it's so cute, a really cute washi dashboard. I'll just smooth out all the edges. And then I can back that with one of those papers or something that I've made there. So let's see what we have. We have the washi, we have the constellations, we've got our planner babe, our totally rad, this gorgeous girl, this piece of vellum, this paper, our jelly, and our thingies. So the ones that go on their own, I'll put separately. So those are all on their own. These two I'll also put on their own because they are see-through. What I should do is punch them. Okay, so that's those pieces, and now it's just to decide what we want to do with these. I think I really want this, well, these three to be kind of features. I don't really want to hide any of them. So this can go on the back of one, and I'm thinking it can go on the back of this one. So I think I need something else to go on the back of both of those, because I don't really want to hide one, if you know what I mean. I think I want them to both be separate. So I'll just put a little bit of glue on here. Okay, that's pretty cute. So again, I'll just mark the center. Is it, I got that the right way around? Yes. Okay, and so then it's just these two. Oh my goodness, okay, cool. So I also made, let me just move this out of the way. I made this vellum the other day. So cute. And I made this vellum the other day, which I wanted to put in this planner as well. So we have to cut those. Okay, so I've got this silver paper here that I could put on the back of one of those from the GP Studio. And I could actually just put it on the back of both. I might do that. Alternatively, I also have this one. So let's see. Oh, so many things. This is why I'm desperate to set up this holo planner, because all of this stuff will be so cute in it. And I think it's going to be more full of vellum and stuff than anything else. Okay, so I'm going to cut this one down. This digital paper with Get It Girl written on it is from Unicorn Planner. I used to be one of her printable squad members as well, and I just love this. I love it. And this is that same foil that I've done the constellations with as well. So this one here, the other one, it was teal, and then this one is the hollow pixel kind of thing. Went to the park this morning and it was raining, but just that kind of soft, drizzly rain that we didn't really notice it so much. I mean, we knew it was raining, of course, but it didn't feel too bad. But then when I got in the car, I realized how wet my hair was. So it was quite a substantial bit of rain. And now I feel like I've got a bit of a sore throat. I hope not. Maybe it's just suggestion, hey? We did laugh a lot, and sometimes, you know, when you laugh a lot, you get a bit of a sore throat. It was quite a hysterical morning, quite a bit of fun. All right, so that's that one, which I'm now going to have to punch as well, and then this one. So can you tell this planner is going to be seriously layered with stuff? Because why not, hey? And that's one of the reasons why I'm really not that bothered about not decorating my dashboards. Not my dashboards, my dividers. Because A, they're busy. And B, I'm going to put this over the top anyway. So, there's not really any point. Now, I've left a little bit of black pen on there, but I'm going to have to just deal with that. Alright, so, let me think. We could put this one on the back of here. Just for fun. Sure, why not? So that's that one. And then I'll do the same. Oh, this one has these beautiful houses on the back that I absolutely adore. But it's okay. It'll be okay. Papers were made to be used. That's what I have to keep telling myself. Papers were made to be used. There's that one from my pocket setup the other day where I had the heart acetate from GP Studio, and it seriously almost broke my heart to cut it. I love that acetate so much, and I don't know if she's ever going to do it again. Okay. Oh, not quite. It's okay. All right. That hopefully is the end of my cutting. So let's see. I'll put these. I need to be punched, so I'll leave them there. And then I think what we're going to do is put this onto here. That's pretty cute. And we're going to put, that's what, that one's done. Okay. And we're going to put this onto here so that we have some cute backings. Okay, cool. I might put the glue on this because the washi is potentially difficult to go over with the glue pen. Should go all the way to the edges, but, and this one, it doesn't matter which way we go because the paper underneath is pretty uniform. There's not an up or down. So pretty basic. I'm not doing anything special. I'm just sticking it so that it's cute. Really, that's all. Oh, and it's really cute. Okay, so I'll use this on the back. That's the right way up. So I'll use it on the back to mark the holes. Beautiful. Now, what I could do with this one is washi frame it, because it is a little bit smaller, the card in the back. But I don't know. I don't know if I really want to. It's beautiful. It's a beautiful piece of art. Let's leave it as is. Okay, that's it. I'm not going to do any more. My stack of washi dispensers is stacking up over here. I think I've got 18 of them in total. And I've got 5 on my bench already. I love them because you can, if you haven't watched my washi organization, and if organization is your thing, then it's a long video, I'm just saying. Go watch it. It is satisfying in the end. But yes, I've organized them into sort of colors and foils and that sort of thing. So it's cool when I'm setting something up or doing a spread or whatever. It's nice to just grab what you think will be the right collection of washies. And today, though, I've been a little... that feels like I've gone far too close to the edge. Did I not line you up very well? No, I did not. Okay, well, let's not use that one as a template. I think I've already drawn the dots on here. I have. Can't speak today, obviously. Now, this is a little hard to get through because it is a lot of washi. Cool. And these ones I still haven't marked yet. Okay. Oh, Gidget's sneezing. This one is a little bit bigger than the others. While I'm here, I'll run on this one as well. I really like this teal foil. It's very different to my usual pink. And that, again, is one of the reasons why I wanted to set up this holo. I really want to do personal size again, just to... It's not something I'm going to use, like, all the time. It's not an everyday planner. So I don't really need it to be big. But also, I wanted to muck about with colours that weren't pink. That looks incorrect, doesn't it? It's apparently not. Let's grab an actual divider, shall we? I really feel like I'm a bit uncoordinated today. No, I'm correct. Okay, it just looks a little bit out of whack, but apparently it's not. And the last one, again, I'm gonna check because I just have to. I'm just thinking, I don't know if I've got any calendars inserts to go in here. I probably do somewhere, but I don't know where they'd be. Alright, so all of this stuff, I might have gone overboard. Alright, so I'll put the vellums there and the non-vellums there, and acetates, I guess, as well, all together. And my divider can go back. And these little decorative items, and then the jelly. Alright, let's get into it. So, right at the front, let's see what we have here. Part of me wants to put this at the front because you can then see it through the... but I also love this. I just love that vellum so much. The constellation could go over that as well, maybe. And then that's what you would see through the front. Oh, yeah, okay. I'm happy with that. Let's try that for now. And I'm thinking if I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 dividers... I've got 4 of these and 1, 2, 3, 4 of those. So I can double up on some. Okay, let's put these together. I'll just put it over. Actually, let's put some paper in. I might need the first one for a calendar. If I can just go find myself a calendar. And then I'll put some of the notes paper in. Or maybe the to-do first. I might put both to-do and notes together. Actually, here's an idea. Let's put the gel in between. And maybe what I'll do is make something just to mark the gel, like something at the top, for a little top tab. You can't use top tabs too well in this planner because the zip is so close to the top. Alright, I think we'll put our... I want to leave her towards the end, actually. Maybe we'll put this one in on its own. I'll just put that there and move this over. Then I'll put some lined paper in. That's a lot of lined paper. And then let's put the whatever in. I feel like I'm running out of all these things, even though I've got a million. We'll throw some grid paper in. put our, because this one is a bit, not dull, but it's less, I'll put that one there, and then I'll put our gorgeous girl at the back here. And she's the one I've cut a little incorrectly, which is a pain. And some grid paper in here. And then finally, some grid paper at the back. Okay, one at a time. It's because I cut it wrong, I think. Put you in the back, maybe I'll scooch more. Okay, let's see how we go in here. Oh, I love it. Okay, so I also have my little planner pouch that I can put in for a pocket. And it could go in the front, but I do like the idea, actually, of it being in the front because I can see through. And then we've got that one. Get it, girl. Let's put the hello there. And I might make some more things a bit like this. Oh, so this has got in the back. If you can't laugh at yourself, life gets pretty dull. I think that's pretty appropriate. So I'll put that there. Okay, now. Let me just back in just a sec. Okay, so let me tell you what I'm thinking. I wanted to have something, like I said, as a top tab for on this jelly page. And I thought, I had this old GP Studio set of stuff, and in here there are these dividers, and these are vinyl, so they're good because you don't have to laminate them. So I could stick one of those at the top. So that is a strong contender. I wanted to find the heart ones that I had last year, though, and I couldn't find them. So the other option is these. Some pink ones here somewhere. These ones. So kind of jewel tones. Then I thought I could maybe have a word or something across the top, but that would mean I'd need something for it to stick to. And I don't have a lot of room once the zip's in. I don't have a lot of room, so I think that's not going to be a good idea. But I'm leaning towards either these, or I can just stick a little heart and one on behind it so that, you know, they're the same then. Does that make sense? They're symmetrical, so you can just put one on the front, one on the back. And I'm thinking that's what I want to do. And I'm thinking even this teal, this pale teal might be a nice color, and maybe the pink, the hot pink as well, or the dark blue and the pink. There is a circle, there's a star, and there's a heart. I'm going to go the dark pink heart. And I should be using my tweezers. That is so cute. Okay, and then I'll put the blue one on the back. It's high enough up that I'm not going to write on it. Like, it's not going to be in the way when I'm writing. And it's low enough that it's not going to get stuck in the zipper. That's it. We got it. Just press it together. That's pretty cute. And I could decorate this. I have these words left over from something else. I could put one of those on there. I'm not sure anything there goes, but I also have some other stickers here my friend Christine gave me, and she has some clear ones in here. I think these are clear. The best is yet to be. That could be cute. Okay, so we've got all of these. I'm thinking, let's have a look at these ones. We've got these unicorn, they're a bit pale. I quite like these words, but they're maybe a bit pale. What I really liked the look of was this unicorn face. I'm going to grab my tweezers for this, I think. I've never decorated a jelly dash before. But I do like that I have this lined paper underneath because I can kind of get it straightish. So there's that. I don't know if you can see the stickers through it, but anyway, we'll try it and see what we think. And these gorgeous little eyes underneath. And I think I want to use the yes. Oh my goodness, this holo jelly is so cool. Okay, I think that's enough. I don't know if I love it. I do love the heart. I think that's pretty cool. But I'm not sure about the rest. In fact, I don't like these. And I'll decide what I think of this. I like it, but I don't know if I like it on here. I think with the words, it's okay to have the outline. I've decided. Just like that. It's too much. Okay, so the other thing I found was this a Gucci girl from Hello Paper Cat that I absolutely adore. So I'm going to pop her, weirdly, just in the back of the planner. Because then, obviously, you can see her through the back. Oh, look at her. She's fabulous. Okay, so that's the basic setup for now. I'll walk you through it, but I'm just thinking I need a charm. Okay, I'm back and I am so sad. So what I wanted to use was this charm I have from Simply Danny Creations. I think this charm is super gorgeous. However, she's missing the rainbow that has broken off in... Don't store your charms in a tin. Because this happens. So this is supposed to go back together. Oh, I'm so sad. So I might send it, see if Danny will take it back and repair it for me, because I just adore it. And how good would it look with this planner? It would just be perfect. Okay, so heartbroken Desley here. So I'm gonna move him to the side. And I'm going to go back to my original idea of maybe sticking one of these poms on. I kind of like the silver one. It's got the sparkle in it. But I do like the pink as well, of course. So, I don't know. Are you mortified that I'm going to cut this apart? I don't use it. I kind of bought it as a photography prop. So, it's not like I use it for anything. And I'm desperately upset about my unicorn rainbow charm, so I'm doing it. I'm snipping it. Oh, I'm so sad. Okay, I've had two things break on me now. The last one was the clasp on my heart on my Valentine's planner. Okay. Oh, this is string. Oh, okay. Didn't think that through. Because that may not fit through the pull. Okay, so not the best job, I'll have to admit, but it's on there and it's kind of cute. And let's see if it's functional. Yes, it's functional. It may not last very long, but I might be able to do something with it later if it breaks. Plus, you know what? I've got a billion more where that one came from. Okay. It's staying put. Okay, that's good. All right, let's have a look at what we've got in here then. I don't know how useful it's going to be to write with this big pom here, but I generally take the pages out, I think, anyway, for a personal size planner. Let's zoom in a touch so we can have a look. I really love the brightness of this. I think it's so pretty. So I have my little planner pouch in the front here that I can pop things in, and often I put like a little washi card in here just to have some washi on the go. And particularly since there's no pockets in this planner, there's nothing else to it, right? This is just all we have. I did have some clips I was going to bring, but let's just go with what we have for now. I think it's okay. So I love that, and it's got this kind of gold marbly effect on the back. Here's my new Constellation paper with the hollow foil, which I love. So that's from Lazny Shop, Laznye. Sorry, I can't pronounce that. And she's having a Valentine's weekend special with the promo code of Valentine. So I've got that with the code. Then we have this also from the same shop, 5% unicorn, 95% planner babe, even though the percent's on the wrong side, but that's okay. And on the back of that, I just have that paper, and I think it goes beautifully with this planner. So I have my first section, which is going to be a calendar, which I don't have in here. Let's have a quick look in the Thrive if I have any. I don't. And at one point I made my own, if you can see here. I use this Milo and Milk stickers to make my own spread. So I may end up doing that instead. But if I can find these weeklies, I might pop them in. Okay, sorry, that was a segue. All right, so that's the first section. And then in the next section, I have this acetate with that same hollow foil. And oh, my cute little washi dash. That's really cute with the silver foil and the silver foil back as well. So this is my to-do list, and then I've got my little jelly dash here separated with a little heart to show where the notes section is. So when we have our meetings, we can I can have my to-do list here and I can have my notes here from the meetings. Then I have my cute little Milo Milk Girl and this Get It Girl vellum from Unicorn Planner, which I love in this teal foil. So cool. And now a second divider. Okay, so this section, I've just got some notepaper in, and then I have this cute, super cute acetate from the Planners Anonymous That's So 90s box with Whatever, My Bad, and Oh Snap, As If on it, totally. And then this gorgeous divider, and then I've got my grid paper, and then this vellum from Elliebeth Designs UK, which is where all the papers are from for the dividers. And I have grid paper in here as well. Grid paper is my favourite paper. And then I have this gorgeous girl. I just love that. It's so pretty. And I backed it with this paper from GP Studio. And then we have this last divider, which is also, of course, Elliebeth Designs UK with some grid paper. And then right in the back, I have my Pumpkin Paper Co. Dashboard with 11. And that's from the season one. And then a couple of sticky notes on the back, and then this business card holder with some cute stickers from Tickle Pink Planning and Lovely Mine. And I don't know what else is in this last pocket. Probably the same, judging by the size. Oh no, there's some little Elliebeth Designs UK stickers in there as well, some cute little tiny ones. Oh, there's a tracker in there. Cool. Okay. And then we have this pocket, which is hollow pocket as well, iridescent, let's go with. We have a little note section at the back of the notebook and pocket here and pocket here. And then right in the back, I have my Gucci Girl card from Hello Paper Cat that I just thought would be cute in the back there. Just have something because it's see-through, because why not? Okay. Oh, I love it. And my pen is the hollow iridescent pen from Kiki K as well, from the Couch Lucky Stars range. Might not exist anymore, that pen. I'm not sure. Okay. That's it. That's my little hollow setup. I can't even. It's so cute. And like I said, I've been wanting to do this for ages. So I'm not too precious about this. It's not an expensive planner, so there's not leather or anything. So I'm okay to just chuck it in the bag. If it gets scratched up, it gets scratched up. And like I said in the beginning, it's shiny enough that you kind of don't really notice any scratches unless you look super closely. And, you know, if you're looking super closely, then you're going to open the planner and look at all the cuteness inside as well, right? It's so cute. Loving, loving, loving it. And it's not as chunky as I thought it would be. I thought I had so much acetate and vellum and stuff in here that I thought it was going to be super chunky, but it isn't. And people have asked if this planner lays flat, and it kind of does. As soon as you open it with your stuff in it, it definitely lays flat. So it's just that it curls at the edges because of the zip, and I think that's totally fine. It may not last forever, but it is so much fun. Oh, I lost you for a second. I was just going to show you my planner stack, just to show you the difference. So I've got my A5 Vintage Rose here. That's my work planner. I've got my B6 Nude, which is my dream life planner, and I adore this setup, which is why I'm thinking my beautiful new quilted, oh my gosh, this planner is so beautiful. I have a plan for this, I'm not sure, but what I'm doing here is showing you this neutral color stack. I have the Coral She Shines planner, which I set up for Valentine's Day, and I love this thing. So really happy with that. But the idea to then add this super crazy fun holographic planner makes me so happy as well. So this is my current little stack. I've got another one. I've got the Dream Planner as well that I'm using for my dream life stuff. And I have my little Naya Papery as well. So none of these are patterned planners. I do have a lot of planners that have a pattern on them, like my Thrive Pink Lavender, and the There She Is, and tons of them. So it is a total change from this time last year, I think, or maybe 2 years ago. I found a picture from Instagram came up as a memory, and almost every planner was patterned. So to now be in a completely neutral set of planners is so different, but I love it. They are gorgeous, and none of these are planners that you would be afraid to take out in front of other people, you know, until you open this gorgeous thing. Oh, I just love it. And I've got a little mild liner in here. I carry my red one too, or pinky red, just to use it to cross off my to-do list, and I think it's super cute in there as well. Anyway, I digress. This video is about the gorgeous holo. So that's it. I am super excited to jump into this. I'm going to be using it tomorrow for a little meeting that we're having about a cool little thing that's coming up. I'll tell you about that when I can. It's not too far away now that I can tell you. So yeah, I'll pop into this tonight to make some notes and get ready for the meeting tomorrow, but I can't wait to start using it. It's so cute, and I love that you can see through it and see all these cute little bits and pieces. Okay, I really will stop talking now. Thank you so much for watching. I'm sorry to ramble. I hope you don't mind. Super excited, as you probably can tell, and I'm going to go now and probably set up my work planner for next week, because it's the weekend and that's what I do. Alright guys, thanks so much for watching and I'll see you all again super soon. Bye!